Dear viewers, today we will talk about the agriculture inputs. It means that all those inputs which are very much needed to perform the agricultural practices. First of all, we will enlist them. These are actually the seed, soil, water, fertilizer, agrochemicals, and farm machinery. These are six basic and foremost important agricultural inputs, so we will discuss them one by one. Very first, starting with the definition of the seed. Seed can be defined in many ways actually. The general perspective of the seed is any material used for planting and for regeneration purpose is called as seed. But the botanically, we can say that fertilized mature ovule along with seed coat is known as seed. Or in more simple words, we can say that ripened ovule or mature ovule is also known as botanical seed. If we move on and try to define it on structural basis, it can be defined as an embryonic plant which have stored food and protective seed coat. It means it has three important components. One is the embryonic plant and stored food that may be in the form of cotyledon or the endosperm and protective seed coat. It may also be defined in a seed technology perspective. Then we say that a sexually produced mature ovule with intact embryo, stored food, and seed coat. By looking at the definitions, we may say that seed technology perspective and seed structural perspective are same. And the next perspective is the horticulture. In this perspective, we will say that propagating material of healthy seedling, which is basically originated from the seeds, or it may be tubers, bulbs, rhizomes, roots, cuttings, and all types of grafts are the horticultural perspective of seed. So, in generally, we can say that the vegetative propagating material used for production purposes is also the horticultural seed. So far as the importance of the seed is concerned, it is very vital agricultural input. It means that without this input, no agricultural practice could be performed. And this is also less costly input as compared to other agricultural inputs. Third, if we work on improving the quality of seed, then we can automatically enhance 20 to 25% yield through manipulation of seed genetics. Seed is also the carrier of new technologies. All the traits improved are carried to the next generations through the seed. Seed is also very important to ensure the food supply. If we talk about the seed, this is the only important agricultural input which can be used to get higher yields even under unfavorable environmental conditions. The next agricultural input is soil. This is important because it provides supports to the plants. It is also a source for the water and nutrients because plants are able to uptake water and nutrients from the soil. Soil is also the house of the insects, worms, nematodes, and other microbes, which are also interacting in different ways with plants. Soil is also important for carbon sequestration and maintenance of gases. Next agricultural input is water. Basically, two types of farming practices are used, irrigated farming and rain-fed farming, but water is important in both cases. Water is a core agricultural input in all type of productivities. Even under uncertain weather conditions, rainfall dependent agricultural system is very badly affected. So, irrigation remains suitable to ensure the water availability. So, if the water availability is ensured, then the risk of crop failure is minimized. There are certain critical growth stages for every crop plant, and water availability should also be ensured at every growth stage of those crop plants. And certain amount of water is also needed throughout the life cycle of the plant, which must also be available. Fertilizers are another agricultural input. Fertilizers are actually available in the form of organic fertilizers, inorganic fertilizers, and many other soil amendments. Organic fertilizers may be the farmyard manure, organic waste, and compost, whereas inorganic fertilizers are nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium in various combinations and various industrially prepared formulations, whereas various soil amendments are used to adjust the soil pH and also to optimize the soil reactions. Agrochemicals are another agricultural input which are used either to protect the crops, maybe from pest, which is helped by the pesticides, and others are the rodenticides, which protect the crop from the rodents, which may be the in-field or even during storage conditions. Herbicides are protecting the crops to compete with weeds. Fungicides are killing the fungus, which is using the plant sources. And antibacterial chemicals, which are used to destroy or demolish the bacterial infections. Whereas many other agrochemicals are there, which have positive role on the crop productivity enhancement, they are in the form of supplements, micronutrients, or maybe the amino acids, which are having positive role on productivity enhancement of crop plants. The next agricultural input is farm machinery. As all of we know that manual work is time consuming and less efficient, whereas mechanical working is more efficient and also needing less time period. And labor cost is also reduced, and time period required to perform certain tasks in the field is also reduced, whereas mechanical practices are also uniform in nature. And the chances of human error is also reduced in mechanical operations. Mechanical operations are also helping in seed grading, processing, sowing, and even harvesting. Machinery is also helping the farmers in preparation of field and many other operations during whole crop season. So we can say that farm machinery is also a very important agricultural input. Now we'll move to another important aspect, that all of these agricultural inputs have their own importance, but their importance or the value is depending upon the availability of capital investment. If a farmer has the financial resources and the financial support, then he can manage to buy all of these agricultural inputs. But if he is unable or is unable to manage the financial resources, then he has to face lot of yield penalties. So governments can help the farmers to overcome the financial barriers with the provision of subsidies or with the provision of free agricultural inputs. Thank you very much.